Ciao friends. Let's solve together a scenario where we need to create a query that computes year by year the top three products, and it also adds one additional row to the output that contains the sales of all the products which are not in the top three. Before jumping into the DAX code, let's review the requirement together. We have, you see already the result here, and we have four rows for 2007, 1, 2, 3, 4, and the first row is Adventure Works, 1.2 million, then we have Aidatum, the third product, and these are the top three sellers in 2007. And then we have this additional row, Others, with 8 million, which aggregates together all the sales of all the products which are not in the top three. And the same repeats year by year. We have the same in 2009 and we have the same in 2007, in 2008. So the problems we need to solve is first iterate year by year, then we will need to compute the top three products, and finally we will have an additional constraint which is creating this new row in the result containing others and the sales of all the other products. While we are building the query, we will also worry about the sort order, because you see that right now the numbers are sorted correctly, meaning that the first value is the highest, then we have the second place, the third place, and the fourth contains others. Others always appears at the end of the list of the top three. So we will have all these problems to solve one by one. Now that the problem is clear, let's jump into the DAX code and let's see how to solve it. We will need DAX Studio, and we need to think about how to solve the problem. As it always happens with DAX, we need to start from the simplest problem and then build the query step by step. The first step will be retrieving the products along with their sales amount. Then we will retrieve the top three, and finally we will elaborate these results in order to add the additional row. Let's save for now the sort order for later, because that requires a bit more thinking. So let's start from the beginning. We need to run a query, so we start with evaluate. As I said, we need the products, and for each product we need the sales amount. So we start with columns. We don't want all the products, so we retrieve just subset of it. We only want the product names. Product and we also want a column containing the sales amount. Let's call it amount. Okay, let's start by looking at the first result, enlarge the font a bit. And we have the product name and the amount. Now, out of this table, we need to retrieve the top three products. So we want to use TOPN. Order by amount. Let's format the query and let's see the result. Now the result contains only three products. Now that we have this first subset, we need to iterate year by year and produce for each year the list of the top three. The function that does it is generate. And we can use we could use values of date, calendar, year. Let's see how it goes. That should return year by year. Oops, year by year the top three products. The thing is, if I run it, I have just too many rows. Actually, I have for 2005. Looks like all the products. And the reason is in 2005, all the products have no sales. Because no products have sales, they are all in the top three. I want to get rid of this effect, so I need to restrict the calculation to only the years when there are sales. That's why it's a good idea to use summarize here. We summarize sales by calendar year. That way, I will only have the years for which I have sales. Let's see the result. Now for 2007, we only have three products, and then three products in 2008, and the same in 2009. So the numbers are correct right now. But this is just a part of the final solution I want to produce. The complete solution need to add another row containing others. And the problem of this row is that it's not any product. So I don't have any product containing these other rows. But I can generate a new table containing only others and the amount. And I add it to the result. So the result will contain the three rows plus an additional row that I will add to the result before returning it through TOPN. That row need to contain others as the description, and for the sales amount, for the amount produced, it need to contain the total sales minus the sales of the top three products. So it's a good idea to start using variables at this point. We store the result of TOPN into a variable, top three products, that only contains the TOPN. Return top three products. By doing that, I'm basically returning the same result as before, but it's in a variable. So I can now work on this variable, create another variable where I will store the sales amount of all the products. So sales of all products. This is just sales amount because I'm already in the filter context generated by summarizer, so I'm fine with that. Then I need the sales of the top three products, the sales of the top three. Actually, the value, the amount, is already computed here because add columns generates for each product the sales amount. TOPN returns only the top three, so I only need to iterate over top three products and sum the amount column. The number is already there, I just need to return it. Now, to check that some numbers are actually returned, I can use this. I created variable here, sales top table, sorry, here. So to see that some number comes out, and 2.6 million should be the value of the top three products in 2007. Then I need the sales of others, and this is the subtraction from sales of all products. I need to get to remove the sales of the top three. This basically returns another number, which are the sales of the other products. Now I have the value that I need to return. I need to create a table containing others and the number that I'm interested into. So I can create a row containing others, which is a table containing two columns. So I need to use parentheses for that. Others, and for the value, for the number, that will be sales of others. Let's see what's in this table. Now it's a table, so I no longer need the curly brackets. And so I have 2007, others, 8 millions, 9 millions, 9 millions. Last thing is I need to add this row to the top three products. So I can now compute the result, which is the union of top three products, the variable containing my top three products, to which I add the row containing others. And I can return the result. Let's reduce this a bit so I can see the entire code. That should work. Let's give it a try. Now I have 2007, the three products that I'm interested into, and where is the others rows? Here they are. At the end, I have others with the value. It's a good idea to sort the data. Order by calendar year. So now I have 2007, the row with others appears here in 2007, and then Contoso Adventure Works, my four products. Actually, the result is nice, but it's not properly sorted because you see that others appears in second place because just because that is the way it was returned. I'm only asking for the sort by calendar year. I can give a try to sort by amount. But it happens that, yes, for the first year it works, for the second year it works, and also for the third year it works. No, actually it is not working because I want the order to be descending by amount. I want the top product to be the first one. And if I do that, I'm in trouble because now others appears as the first row and I want it as the last in the year. So what I need to do is I need to create a new column that I add to the result that will contain 1, 2, 3, 4. So I force the order. And I want Adventure Works to be first because that is 1 million. Second, I'm fine with Adatom SLR. Third is fine Contoso. Others need to be fourth. So I want the most, I want the best product to be first, the second to be second, and so on. That looks like a ranking is a good option. So I need to rank this table, the table containing these three rows, with an additional column 1, 2, 3 that I need to add to top three products. I can do that. Top three products. Let's call it ranked. Then do a rank X over top three products based on amount. Now that should return 1, 2, 3 in top three products ranked. And then instead of using top three products, I use top three products ranked. If I run it, I get beautiful an error that says column amount cannot be found. There's no amount. Why that? Oh, I'm using top three products ranked. Yes, that should not be a rank X. Rank X returns a number that should have been at columns to top three products. Position. Rank X over top three products. I wasn't creating the column, so now I have it in top three products ranked. Let's run it again. We still have an error. Each table of union must have the same number of columns. Right now I'm unioning top three products ranked that now contains an additional column pose, which is not present here. Let's put 0 just as a test. With a comma, not a dot. Okay, so now we have the additional column, 1, 2, 3 for the first rows. The problem is still with others, I use 0, but if I know that 1, 2, 3 are always the first three, I can just use 4. So I run it again, and I need to sort not by amount, but by position. Ascending because I want 1 to be the first. Okay, now I have it. I have 2007, 4 rows. There is this new row others that I added to the result containing 8 million. And the sort order is not defined by the amount or the product name, but by this additional column that I created in the model, in the result of the query. And I guess problem solved. As you have seen, when it's time to write code that is not trivial, that requires some time to be thought, you never start from the beginning and then you write the entire code. At the beginning of this query, you have no idea that you will use generate or summarize or that you need all those variables. The need arises while writing the code and while discovering what you need step by step. You always start from the innermost expression, which is typically the simplest of the entire query, and then you add complexity one step at a time until you generate a query that, although looks complex, is actually not that hard if you follow how it has been built. Enjoy DAX!